buffalo bowls back to school.
Why come up with it now, as a before or later?
Okay, I didn't come up with it. I had a notion that it was interesting to put together a collection of all those old tracks that I'd made with the Supreme Team back in the early 80s, 1980, 81. Simply because there's been so many people using those tracks wherever they could find them, old 12 inches, 45s and whatever, because they've been deleted for some time, and using them to sample and actually influence a lot of hip-hop records over the past 5 or 10 years, particularly, of course, in the United States, right down to Puff Daddy's recent tracks with Mariah Carey or even Janet Jackson on her album Velvet Rope. I realized that it was time to deliver that group of tracks on one album. They've never been on compilation albums, like, you know, hip-hop compilations or greatest hits, best of, blah, blah, blah. And I wanted to do it not in a crappy, cheap, tacky way. I wanted to do it as to show the origins and the roots of how that music really came about. So I wanted to present it in a really, in a way in which I could at least show how, in my own way, I discovered hip-hop, and how, in effect, I'd also created a friendship with a lot of black artists in the United States. And it was from that point that I then took up with some guys who were hanging in New York, a kind of remix team called Hard Boiled. And they had friendships with KRS-One and De La Soul, Tribe Called Quest, Rakim, who hadn't at that time, I have to say, even delivered his recent album.
You're so pretty, you are your dancing just to get with me. You're so jiggy, your style's original. You're so pretty, your style's addictive.
The place packed in the club is to hit the guard.
My label contacted me and told me that Malcolm McLaren's people was doing a remix of the old hits that he'd done, and you know, me being a Malcolm McLaren fan from years ago, Buffalo Girls, Hobo Scratch, Hey DJ, you know what I mean? It was like, you know, perfect opportunity to show somebody that I respect and love.
And why did you choose Buffalo Girls to work on?
Well, Buffalo Girls, you know what I mean? It was a hot track, you know what I mean? Back in the day when it came out, it was hot, everybody was feeling it. But there wasn't no rhymes on it. So I figured, you know, I'd take that one there and try to make it a little special or whatever, put a little Rock Hill flavor. And my man, I saw 7 from Brooklyn, came down, did a verse with me on a joint. You know what I mean? But Buffalo Girls was a hot joint back in the day.
Yo, are you dancing just to get with me? You're so jiggy, your style's original. You're so pretty, your style's addictive.
When Malcolm McLaren dropped that years ago, they was classics, and they still classics. So what hip hop and rappers and everybody do now, they look for flavor. And they look for sometimes flavor that everybody's familiar with. So you know, Malcolm McLaren's gonna get a lot of his stuff sampled and chopped up and little hooks here and there, cause it was hot and everybody remember.
Dressed to tear 'em, men dare 'em to wear 'em, staring as I get near 'em, and then I enter, they hear 'em, they get.
Soul Son, DJ Scars, Hardball Entertainment for the millennia.
You're my Babylon, you're my Babylon.
Special dedication to Malcolm McLaren and the world famous Supreme Team.
Well, there's a lot of history behind it. When McLaren first met Afrika Bambaataa, world famous, all of that, their narratives going on the album via interludes and stuff like that. So there's a lot of learning.
Yeah, I did produce some tracks in the album as well as the interludes, and Malcolm is telling the story when he was at the Zulu Nation party in the early 80s with African Mbada, and he was like the witness of all that was happening there, all the discipline of hip hop culture, like DJing, breakdancing, graffiti artists, and all that. And I thought it was really interesting to have those information in that record. You have in this album two up and coming artists like Soul Sun,
Boogeyman. Boogeyman does more of a spoken word types of work. Takala is another spoken word artist. They're all involved in that. It comes together real nicely because spoken word is another thing that's banging over here in the US right now. And I also heard it's happening too in the UK, though I haven't seen it there. So this album goes full circle. It touches on the past, hits you with what's currently happening with the younger artists like we mentioned, Soul Sun, Hannibal Lecter, Takala.
It's just something about it that it just gets all up in your anal bone, like right around the hand, it just makes you just do, you know what I'm saying?
I don't know, I'm saying.
You know what? My mind was a world famous Supreme Team. Hey, DJ.
Mm-hmm.
I just love that joint. I don't think the voice was bad. Actually, it was just a different flavor. And it wasn't some, you know, because a lot of times you get caught up in the same, right here in the same thing. So it was just different flavor, and it had flavor to it. And, you know, flavor, you just recognize. I think they brought a different eye, you know what I'm saying? Because just like listening to his interview and his experience with the Bronx, it was something new to him. And you know, sometimes you can't see the forest for the trees. And you deal with what you know and your surroundings. So when then people come outside, it's like outside influences. And now how they're using like classical and stuff and hip hop. You know, most inner city kids can't recall anything, you know, classical except what they hear, like, you know, what it is, one of their classes or something. So you can bring that in and make a nice meld, you know, so it works out when you have different perspectives coming in.
Yes, white, Soul Sun, the iron shirt, hard to hurt. Doing my thing with scars, hardcore style. Yeah. Bring the rap in a team. You know what I mean? Dad, we do this for the 9-7, 9-8, all the way through the millennium. Bring back the true school, you know what I mean?
As with any art form, it's the, you know, the main impact it has on the individual is how it makes you feel, you know? And so one of the big assets, you know, of artists, especially hip-hop artists, is they can elicit a feeling from you from a lyric. You know, one of the big things with a lot of the elaborate videos and a lot of the elaborate visuals is that it took away from that. You didn't have to do that anymore because the video does it for you. You know, I mean, you've got artists like, for instance, Rakim or KRS-One. They came from an era when all they had was a microphone and two turntables. That's it, and a stage. And you had to create the image. You had to literally control the crowd. You know, you had to do that. If you didn't, you know, you have to have an idea in your head, and you have to be able to project that idea onto the crowd and have all of them feel it, and have all of them feeling you. You know, and the whole, you know, a lot of the elaborate videos and a lot of other things were made to, on the business end, to sell records. You know, and, you know, there's a difference. I mean, there's nothing wrong with that, but there's a difference. You kind of made it not as essential for the artist to be able to convey that vision, you know, to convey that idea to the, you know, to the consumer.
Malcolm McLaren is a classic. It's a blessing to KRS-One to be even working with him.
I can smash that ass and you would like it.
kid. No need to hype it, but Karis was the one that piped it. This lyrical freestyles me while you getting excited. Rippery and jittery over my delivery. I'm glittery. I rhyme against bigotry. Why you giving me ignorance, incompetence, inexperience? I'm not hearing it. I battle with expedience and obedience. You lacking the ingredients. Hip hop, you not being it. You trying it. My whole style right now, you eyeing it. I'll take your dog demo and put the sky in it. You say you don't want like an Elvis Presley CD. I ain't buying it. Tell me the relevance of rhyming without intelligence. There is none. Experience equals wisdom. MCs, I flick them. Lyric, lick them. Trick them. Kick them. Ha, ha, ha. Stick them. Yeah, yeah, yo. Now every now and then I kick this style and get you open. I read minds and rhymes while I'm floating. I know you open for something different, more gifted, uplifted. Topical, if impossible, while rocking you. Let me give it to you.